Concept 8 is power. In our textbook, power is found in section 5.5. Power is the rate at which energy is transferred. So it is a rate. And so when we talk about power, we use this equation, work over time, because it's a rate. Just like distance over time is a rate, it's how much work per second or work per hour or whatever the unit you are measuring in. So it is work over time. The SI unit of power is the watt, and 1 watt equals 1 joule per second. That should make sense looking at this because work is measured in joules, time is measured in seconds, and so a watt is 1 joule per second. A little bit of confusion, don't get work and watts, the W's, confused. Make sure you're able to separate those out and you know which one is work and which one is watts. Usually it is apparent through the context. Usually you can tell from context whether you're talking about work or watts. The British unit of power is the horsepower. And so a lot of times in the US we hear the phrase horsepower, but the SI unit is the watt. And a horsepower is 550 feet pounds per second or 745.7 watts. Question 21, what are the units given on an electric bill from a power company? Do you pay for energy or for power? You might not know this. Do you know what's on the power, the energy bill? When you get a bill from the electric company, what is it measured in? Do you know what it's measured in? It's actually measured in kilowatts. And so that is power. It is measuring your power. Let's do one little example here. It's actually two examples kind of stuck together in one. How much energy does a 75-watt incandescent light bulb use compared to a 20-watt compact fluorescent lamp? That would be a CF lamp. If both are left on for 8,000 hours. So 8,000 hours seems like a long time. We could do some division there and see how long that is. But when they are selling light bulbs, they have to tell you the efficiency of that bulb. So that's kind of what we're talking about here. Okay, so energy used is the work done, and the work done is power times time. If we go back to our equation here, if we're solving it for work, if we're solving this for work, we would multiply both sides times T, and so work is power times the change in time. We just rearrange that equation. So work is power times time. So how much energy does a 75-watt incandescent light bulb use compared to a 20-watt CF lamp? Let's just work out this problem. For incandescent, the power we're talking about is in watts. It is 75 watts. The time is 8,000 hours. And if we multiply that out, we get 600,000 watt hours, which typically what we do is we call them kilowatt hours. And so we would need to divide that by 1,000 and we would get 600 kilowatt hours. And so again, this is what the power company is charging you for. They're charging you for the kilowatts. And then the hours is how long you left it on. All right, compact fluorescent are these popular bulbs that we have now. And so now we're saying it's not a 75 watt, it's a 20 watt. And most of the light bulbs, if you go to the hardware store, they give you sort of a comparison. Like it'll say a 20 watt, but it's comparable to a 75 watt because 75 watt is what a lot of people are used to. And 20 watt is the new version of that. So then we multiply that again times 8,000, and we get 160,000 watt hours. Or if we divide by 1,000, we would get 160 kilowatt hours. Then the question asks, what is the total cost for each if energy costs 13 cents per kilowatt? So in other words, if we take this and we multiply it by 13 cents, how much is that going to cost us? And same thing down here. If we multiply this times 13 cents, how much will that cost us? And so we multiply it out, and the incandescent comes out to be about $78, and the compact fluorescent comes out to be about $20.80. So the question is, which one do you want to buy? Well, if you look at these two numbers and compare these two numbers, it's about a fourth of the cost. So if you're looking to save money on your energy bill, you would change over to an efficiency bulb, a CF, a compact fluorescent bulb. The incandescent, the kind of old-fashioned ones, a lot of people like them because they're used to them, but they are about four times more expensive to run as a compact fluorescent. Okay, so that's all this video needed to cover was just power, and again, we will continue to work with power throughout the unit.